Hi, I'm Brittany with the State Personnel Board, and today we're answering one of your questions about pay grades. Okay, today's question from one of you is, why can't an employee keep their position but move up to a different pay grade for a pay increase rather than move closer to market? Well, because each classification is assigned to one pay grade. We cannot have one classification using multiple pay grades for pay equity purposes. Instead of moving employees up to a different pay grade, use the zones within the pay grade for the increases. Each pay grade has a minimum salary, market salary, and a maximum salary. These salaries are based on relevant labor market data. Each pay grade is also made up of four zones. Zone 1 starts with the minimum salary and goes up to 10% above the minimum. Zone 1 is used for entry-level employees that have little to no related experience and require active supervision and training. Salary decisions within Zone 1 are made at the agency level and are subject to equity audits by MSPB staff. Zone 2 salaries are salaries up to market. This is for employees who have minimal prior closely related experience. Salary decisions within Zone 2 are made at the agency level and are subject to equity audits by MSPB staff. After Zone 2 is the market salary, which is established by MSPB. Zone 3 is market to up to 10% above market. This is for employees with previous closely related experience, and these employees have demonstrated the ability to perform their duties with minimal training. Salary decisions in Zone 3 are subject to equity audits by the State Personnel Director or designee prior to approval. Zone 4 is between 10% above the market salary and the maximum salary. Zone 4 is reserved for employees who have exemplary performance, a broad and deep knowledge of the position and related areas, and or possess scarce skills or highly valued licenses or certifications. The amount of difficulty to recruit suitable candidates can also be considered in paying in Zone 4. Any appointments or salary increases in Zone 4 require approval by the Mississippi State Personnel Board at a board meeting, with the exceptions of the qualifications listed in Section A6 of the VCP. As a reminder, in January 2023, 20 plus years of experience related to the current classification was added as a qualifier that is exempt from board approval. But keep in mind that this exemption is still bound by the 10% maximum increase for in-range adjustments. As a reminder, all of our pay grades and policies surrounding our pay grades and the zones can be found in our variable compensation plan. Our variable compensation plan, as well as other policies, are on our website at www.mspb.ms.gov. As always, if you have specific questions, please contact your HR analyst.